Though the cloud may hover over us, there's a bright and golden ray . It is the promise, yeah, Lord, that in heaven, God shall watch. All our tears away.
Gonna be a bright eternal morning.
Bright,
oh yeah.
Eternal morning.
Early in the morning, when I rise, God promised He'd wipe.
Whoa. right in confidence. One thing if I desire of the Lord, that will I seek after. That I may dwell in the house of the Lord the days of my life. So we heard that beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me his pavilion. The secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. Now shall my head be with me, but my enemies round about. Sacrifices of joy, I will sing yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. Instead of seeking my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I see. Hide not thy face far from me, put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy will, Lord. Lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over into the will of mine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, such as breathe out cruelty. I have fainted, unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Psalmist David encourages us to wait on the Lord and to be of good courage, because he alone shall strengthen our hearts. Wait, I say, on the Lord. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice. Land in it. Grateful for you being here today, on the PDK family. We're going to ask that Pastor Gilmore Brown, who's our host today, will come and give the welcome, followed by Bishop Ross with the opening prayer, and then we will continue with our service. But we will worship the Lord today in the beauty of holiness. Pastor Brown.
Let's praise the Lord, everyone. Let's praise the Lord. We say goodbye to a believer, an icon, a true servant of God, a true servant of the Lord. So we should be praising the Lord on this day, because we've been called home after a lifetime of faithful service. Amen. Amen. So in the midst of our sadness, there is joy, knowing that he's gone to a better place. My name, for those of you who do not know me, Pastor Gilroy Brown, pastor of Mount Shiloh Church. And I'd like to welcome you all to Mount Shiloh Church today. To Mother Peterkin, family, we have family also. We please accept our condolences today on behalf of myself, my wife, and Mount Shiloh brethren. We share your loss, and we are also here to make sure that the whole Lord service today is one that befits this man, this great man, Elder Peterkin, Elder Joshua Peterkin. Special greetings also to our clergy, our Bishop Ross, our Bishop Shirley, our Overseer Dino, our Bishop Des Edmonds, our Elder Campbell, and our Bishop Raymond Williams. God bless you. At this moment, I'll hand over to our Bishop Ross in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord. Let me greet all the bishops and pastors and ministers of the gospel and the bereaved family. God bless you. Let's bow our heads now in prayer unto the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we give you thanks for today. We thank you, Lord, because you are God and God alone. Hallelujah. You create and you destroy because you are God. Father, we are standing here with a mixed feeling, my God, because one of our beloved brother, God, you have taken. Hallelujah. I thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for each and every one that gathered together, because the time will come when each and every one of us will be taken away from this land. Hallelujah. To be with you, Lord. Holy Father, we thank you. We pray especially for all those who gather around right now to pay the last respect to the man of God. But Father, especially to the children and grandchildren, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I commit them in your hands today. Help them to realize that date of the time to steal us away. We are not expecting that arrive. But I thank you, God, my Savior, for the life of Pastor Peter Kim. I thank you for him. And I thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. You take him out of sickness. Hallelujah. And we pray and we know by the grace of God that assists in us, his soul of fine, a resting place in God. And Lord, we pray right now in the name of Jesus. Bless the children and their children. Hallelujah. That they may live a life that counts, the one that the daddy laid down. I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Take over for us. Let everything be said and done to your divine glory. That when the hour of departing out of this building, our soul refreshing, my God, Mother Peter Kim, touch her with your mighty hands right now, Lord. Touch her. Help her to know that her husband is resting out of pain and aches. I know it's hard, because when one depart who are so loving, but I commit your mother in the hands of God today. Trust in the Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Lord. Bless each and every one right now. All the visitors, bless them, Lord. Be with them and be with their parents. And bless all the ministers that are here. God, my Savior, I see Bishop Raymond. Hallelujah. You know what? Hallelujah! I wish that somebody would shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. His name is worthy to be praised. From the uprising of the sun, even unto the going of the same. Bless and sanctify us together right now while I lead the family into your hands. Cover them under your blood, Lord. Cover them. They need a covering. And we thank God for the minister that give us the access to be under this building. Pray to bless him also in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord.
We praise the Lord this morning and we give God thanks for his kindness. God is a good God. Amen. God is a good God. And he is indeed worthy to be praised. Anyone that is here today know that Elder George Leroy Peter King was a worshiper. He was a worshiper. He was a prayer warrior. And I have a feeling that he would want us to celebrate his passing the way that he lived his life. And he lived it. He was not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. He was not ashamed about being baptized in Jesus' name. He was not ashamed about being filled with the Holy Ghost. And guess what? We're not going to be ashamed about it in this service. We're going to lift our voices. We're going to bless him. Hallelujah. We're going to honor him. We're going to give God praise because he is indeed worthy. For those of you that can stand, hallelujah, with the exception of the family, those of you that can stand, hallelujah, let's stand together and sing this great hymn of the church. 'Tis a sweet and glorious thought that comes to me. I live on. Yes, I'll live on. We will follow, amen, and join with our praise singers this morning. Let us sing to the honor and glory of the Lord's name.
Yes, I live on. spirit. If you know that you're going to live on, clap your hands and give God praise today. My, that is the assurance that we have.
Amen. We will live on.
Yes.
And we thank God for that hope, for that assurance, for that comfort. Because while we live, we do not live without a hope. We live in the knowledge that we will live on. We have an extended program here today, and the family has selected those that they would participate in the service. And I know that Elder Peter King would want the word preached today. I'm going to say it one more time. I know that Elder Peter King would want the word preached today.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And we have an able preacher to do it. And so I'm going to ask as politely as I can that those outside of the family will honor the request, and let us move through the program as swiftly as we can. Coming now to read Psalms 91 is granddaughter Tatiana. This will be followed by reflections by Minister Earl Campbell. Then after Minister Earl Campbell, we will have another reading by Doreen Gerald, who is an adopted daughter. Please come in that order. Tatiana, followed by Minister Earl Campbell, followed by Doreen Gerald. If you prepare yourselves and get ready, then you can come one after the other. God bless you.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet, because He hath set His love upon me. Therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him with long life. I will satisfy him and shew him my salvation. The word of the Lord is already blessed. Amen.
Praise the Lord, brethren.
Hallelujah.
Well, Peter King would want more than that. Come on, we praise the Lord, brethren.
Hallelujah.
Come on, let's praise the Lord again.
Hallelujah.
It gives me a great pleasure today to stand here today on behalf of the Dudley Assembly, which Elder Peter King been a pastor for many years. I bring you condolences from the brethren who could not be here today. Also, the church of the Wolverhampton district, all pastors, if they were to be here today, this building could not hold them. And the Bethel United across the UK, I traveled all over Britain with Elder Peter King.
True.
I came into the hand of Elder Peter King in 1978. My little wife down there, silly little down there, but thanks be to God, I fall into a good hand. And so all the place I knew, the church I knew, because I traveled with Elder Peter King. He was a traveler. Mighty God, mighty, and today you would like to know that somebody in this building gives their life to Jesus. That would make his day. Wherever he goes, he left a mark. Somebody get the Holy Ghost. Mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. And so today, I want to tell the families, we'll back you up in our prayers. Because Elder Peterkin, we'll never forget him. How can you forget a man like that? Praise the Lord Jesus. So be encouraged today. Be encouraged that he lives on. In eternity, he lives on. Praise the Lord Jesus. And you know, we are praying for you. And others all over the world is praying for you. Amen. God bless you all.
Praise the Lord. I must say that I'm privileged and honored to be here, to have been asked to do this reading. I've known Pastor Peterkin, I'll call him Father Peterkin, for many years, and I can remember the very first day that I met him. That will ever stay in my heart. And he was always saying, I've been praying for your door. And also, the reason why I'm privileged to read this psalm today is because Pastor Peterkin gave this psalm to my mom when she wasn't well. And when I heard that this was the psalm that I was going to be reading, it touched me. So thank you, Father Peterkin, for all that you've done for my life. So Psalm 27, it has been read already, but I'm privileged to read it again. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing that have I desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in a time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. And now shall my head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, my cry. When I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. When thou said, seek ye my face, my heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face from far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of my enemies. Deliver me not unto the will of my enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. I have fainted unless I have believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Amen.
We certainly thank Tatiana and Minister Campbell, and we thank Doreen for the way that they have presented here today. We continue in our worship, beloved, and we will sing together another great hymn of the church, song we know well. As I journey through the land, singing as I go, pointing souls to Calvary, to the crimson flow. Once again, I invite you to stand, those that are able, and let us together as a congregation lift up our voices and sing as Elder Peter King would want us to sing today, in the name of the Lord.
Favorite choruses. Amen. These are the songs that he loved. Something in my soul like a spirit. Oh, makes me feel so happy, happy as can be. Oh, when I'm in my Jesus, I don't need to talk. Oh, something in my heart like a spirit. Oh, something in my heart like a spirit. Oh, it makes me feel so happy, as happy as can be. Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. 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 How many people running for their life? We're trying to make 100. Hallelujah. Because we know that 99 and a half just won't do.
And that is what the example of Elder George Peterkin, that's the legacy that he has left for us, that we must run. Hallelujah. And I think he would want me to say, don't try to make it, make it. Hallelujah, because 99 and a half won't do. I am blessed today to be a part of this service, and Pastor Gilroy has already introduced the bishops and the pastors and overseers that are here, and we give God praise for each and every one. Pastor Gilroy, we appreciate your hospitality, and Lady Phoebe and the staff here at Mount Shiloh. But I think we all know Mount Shiloh would not be big enough to host all those that would be attending this service today if it was not for COVID-19. Elder Peterkin has touched the lives of men and women around the world. Hallelujah. And I can testify that I am one of the many that you will hear say this. I was 12 years old. I'm now 58 years old. I was 12 years old when I received the infilling of the Holy Spirit in the hand of Elder George Leroy Peterkin. And I remember very clearly the day before he would come to the home in January for 2 weeks of fasting. And he would put us all on fasting. Amen. We were 11, and my brother and I, we were 11 and 12, and we were doing those times 6 to 6 fasting at 11 and 12 years old. And when we came in from school, Elder Peterkin would be, well, first of all, he woke us up in the morning praying. You would wake up in the morning and you would hear him praying. And when we got home from school, just about 5:45, he would call us to prayer. And the day before I was filled, he was praying for us, and I know now what I was travailing. And I'm saying, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And he looked, after the prayer meeting, he looked at me, he said, in these words, Brother Dexter, you're soon filled. Just like that. That was the Tuesday. And on the Wednesday night in Cardiff, I received the infilling of the Holy Ghost. We used to call him the mixer. Amen. We used to call Elder Peterkin the mixer because those giant hands, when he put it on your head and he rock your head from side to side, rock you until the Holy Ghost fill you. Hallelujah. My prayer for the church is that he is gone, but that his anointing remains. That is my prayer for the church, because this kind of anointing, we need it now more than ever before. Hallelujah. We need this anointing. We need this deliverance anointing now more than ever before. Can we just put our hands together and give God praise for the legacy and life of the Honorable Elder George Leroy Peterkin? We have so many anecdotes, so many stories, so many, time would not permit us. We are now going to ask members of the family to come with family tributes. Peter, Timothy, Christian, Tanya is here all the way from Brooklyn, New York, or New York, New York. We're going to ask you to come now. Peter, Timothy, Christian, Tanya, come with the tributes for your father. Amen. God bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I've just put a few words together, and I'm going to struggle to get through it, but I'm going to do my best. I put these few words together for your dad, and it's called My Dad. As I've heard you say on countless occasions, Dad, and I will endorse those words on behalf of you by saying I must give honour to the Spirit of God. It was so surreal. It's so surreal to stand here celebrating your life, my mind awash with thoughts and great memories of you. Sorry. Time would fail me today to pay you the kind of accolade your life warrants. But as you constantly remind me, it's not what man says about you, but what God says about you. I'm going to miss you, Dad. Those words of wisdom you would prompt me, warning me of life's pitfalls at the grand old age of 60. I've loved and love you, Dad, and always listened to what you have to say. Hence, I stand here weak but strong, strong being the choice words. Please don't say, don't cry, son. I will cry and stop and smile at the legacy you left me, Dad. Ooh, you taught me the art of personal hygiene. As a young boy, barking at me with a bowl of hot water in that broad Jamaican accent, wash on the armpit, boy. And to this day, I have applied those principles. Rest in peace, Dad. God loves you and welcomes you home. Thank you, and sorry, I apologize.
You could never envisage how hard this really is until it's you standing up here. And to date, this is the most hardest and painful thing that I've ever had to do. I remember being about 8 or 9 and getting to Leg Street and Jonathan saying to me, are you going to call him Dad or Granddad? I can't remember what I said, but without a shadow of a doubt, he definitely is my dad. He raised me, and my earliest memories are lying on his lap and scratching my hair to sleep. The man who took me to get my first haircut. The man who'd want to spend £50, he wouldn't want to spend £50 on a pair of trainers, but would buy me any suit of my choice. On a Sunday, me and Jonathan, top and tailing in the bed, and Daddy would come in the room and he would go, st, st. And me and Jonathan would pretend to sleep, and then he would come back in again, st, Christian, time for church, man. And we'd get up and go. I remember when I was meant to be in for 6:30 on a Friday night to get ready for church, and I was late to come back in, and I was dirty, and he scrubbed me in the shower. And I learned very quickly that if I wanted to live long, that don't mess with him when it comes to God. His love for God and his brethren in the church was unquestionably the most important thing in his life. I remember I was messing about a lot at school, and whether you call him husband, dad, granddad, brother, uncle, Elder Peterkin, or just George, we can all agree on this. He was caring, loving, kind, funny without even trying, charismatic and infectious. He was the perfect example of how to serve God properly, an extraordinary man who thought he was just ordinary, but most of all, the man who made prayer the most important thing in his life. When I got sick in 2006, he came to all of my hospital appointments to support me until I told him, it's okay, Dad, I can do it on my own. And when my health deteriorated and they told me that I had to have a transplant, he turned around and said, I'll give you one of mine. At 85 years old, he said, I'll give you one of mine. Dad, I just want you to know that we love you, and I thank you for everything that you've done for me. Your memory will live on forever. You're a legend, and I say this on behalf of our whole family. Good night, our King. We'll never forget you.
I didn't write anything. Because there's not a lot I can say. he loved God more than anything in this world. And right now he's in the place that he loved the most. Even when 2019, when I was in England, he always looked at me like his little girl. He would say to me on a Sunday morning, who is getting to church? Even though I had my own offering, he would say, take your offering. I'm gonna miss him dearly to my heart. He will never be forgotten, ever. He will always be right here. In the most important place. I love him. I love him. And he loved everybody. He was never partial. Whether you were saved or not, he loved you. He just wanted everybody to know who God was. That's all I have to say. I love you, Dad, forever and ever and ever. There's no amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I'll echo what my brother said. Firstly, I must give honor to the Spirit of God. That's what Dad always said, and that's what Dad would want from us, because God is first and foremost, and everything else follows. God has been the foundation of our life, and it's been Dad that has imprinted and made that mark on us. You know, I've said the bigger the impact, the bigger the pain. But I know that God is my strength. Every single time, God is our strength. No matter what we're going through, God is our strength. He will hold things together when everything else is falling apart. In the midst of confusion, he is in it. He knows everything about everything. He is above all things, he's beneath all things, and he's around all things, because he is God. I just want to sing a song, please, before I just say what I need to say. Dad loved to hear me sing, and Dad always used to say, go on, go on, go on and sing. Go on and sing. That was Dad's words. So I'm going to sing to the glory of God for my father.
Standing here, not knowing how we'll get through this test. Face you know best, and nothing can take you by surprise. You got this figured out, and you're watching us now. And even then, we think we can win.
my daddy, my hero. Once again, firstly, I must give honor to the spirits of God. Dad, I wrote this the other day. Dad, as I sit here in your dressing gown, tears rolling down my face, the wonderful memories of you consume me. Reflecting how I remember you shouting me up for school with your booming voice, Timothy, Timothy, come on, you're going to be late. Then you would make me a cup of tea, which tasted like brook splash on, due to the fact that you had just had a wash. Also the times when I was tired just before bedtime, and you would choose to sing to me Mullachintyre by Paul McCartney, just to wind me up. And I would say, Mom, Mom, tell him to stop. I remember trying to correct the way you spoke when you used to say, it's warm. I used to say, Dad, it's not warm, it's warm. Dad, you were a living joker. I once told you that I was going to apply for the fire service, to which you replied, what? With how you lit? By the time you reached the fire, the place burned down. It's right what they say. You can take the man out the country, but you can't take the country out the man. The way you love Mom, your wife, girlfriend, was, in your words, something else. You loved her wholeheartedly, but I think it's safe to say you love God a little bit more. You always had a love for sport, football, Wolves being your team, boxing, speaking about all the greats, and wrestling. Oh, and not forgetting the cricket, the West Indies. You often reminded us not to neglect our prayer life. Don't forget to do the groundwork, you used to say, were your words. And that the devil hates humility. And that down on your knees, you are taller than trees. Your name should have been George Humble Peterkin, because that's exactly what you were. You were realer than real, and you did not compromise with sin. Dad, you were cut from a different cloth. You were tailor-made by Jesus. You used to say, we are blessed and we don't even know it. You left no stone unturned. You've given us all the ingredients to move forward in this life. You were more than just a father. You were a friend, a mentor, a man full of godly wisdom, and a comedian. As Jamaicans would say, you know, normal. As Jesus, after Jesus, you were the most perfect human being to have walked on this earth. My heart breaks, but I am so happy for you. You used to say, God, give me souls for my wages, and to invest in God, because his business is never bankrupt. And you have achieved your ultimate goal, a crown in glory. Amen. Your work on earth is finished, but your work isn't finished. With God's help, I aim to make you proud. I will never forget the last words you said to me, being thanks for everything. That means the world to me. Well, Dad, thank you. Dad, you're simply the best. Forever in my heart, true love never dies. Love you always, your son Timothy and the young prophet Tyler. God bless you, Dad. I love you.
What a blessing. We appreciate so much the time that we have.
This is Holly Sheesh. Would you like to say a little something?
Come on, please.
This is his granddaughter.
This is the granddaughter.
Yeah.
I know my granddad loved me and I loved him, and I'm still praying for him. And I remember when I was little, he used to hold me between his legs and used to do the swing and used to throw me in the air and catch me. And I remember when I was at the church, he used to say, get up and just praise the Lord, Holly, you always praise the Lord. We love you with all my heart. And he used to give me some cuddles. And I remember when I was at the church, he used to say, sit in the back, Holly. And he used to tell everybody that he loved them and everything. And he was a nice, kind man and kind-hearted soul man. And I will never forget you with all my heart. You always will be. And you were an angel up there looking down at me and just like cheering with all the angels. And I hope you're up there talking to my aunt, to my nan, or Darren, and Rochelle. Say hello to them all for me and tell them I love them with all my heart. And I tell them that I love my granddad with all my heart and soul. And he was my everything and always will be. And praise God and praise the Lord.
God bless you. We appreciate these tributes coming from the family. For those of us who have sat in the Peter King seat today, we know how difficult and challenging this day can be. But can we give the family a hand? Let's just bless them. And I want to take a moment to honor the matriarch of the Peter King family. Tim just said it. We know that Elder Peter King loved God with all of his heart. But then the next one that he loved with all of his heart was his beloved wife for over 60 years. 66 years, the Honorable Mother Lily Peter King. God bless you. She is a lover of lizards. That's just a private thing. She knows that she really doesn't love lizards, but on her first trip to Jamaica, she was introduced to lizards in the bed. And ever since then, so we bless God for her. We are coming to the word of the Lord, and we're now going to ask Tema Hewitt to come with the eulogy. Amen. At this time, the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
George Leroy Peterkin was born the eldest child of 9 children on the 24th of January, 1932, to Prudence and Aubrey Peterkin in the district of Hanover, Jamaica. He was raised in a loving, prayerful home and attended Claremont Elementary School, where he received a formal education. He came from humble beginnings and was cherished by his mother, who would never allow his father to send him out to cultivate the land with his siblings, but always insisted he stay home with her. Her words to Mas Aubrey, "Not judge, met the others dem gwan, make judge steer with me." I guess you could say George was pretty much a mama's boy who was always sitting around his mother while she prayed and spoke about the goodness of God. It was there that the seed of faith was planted. As George matured in the coming years, he relocated to Kingston, where he pursued trade school and went on to be a postmaster, working with the Kingston General Post Office. In 1952, at the age of 20, George emigrated to the UK, where he settled in Wolverhampton. By this time, he had convinced himself that after leaving his mother's home, in his own words, he was going to spread his wings and get away from all the loud praying. Little did he know, God had already placed a calling on his life. Soon after arriving in the UK, he started work at A.J. Vaughan in Wolverhampton, then went on to work at Garrington's in Bromsgrove. George was also a social guy and loved to spend time with his friends. One night in August 1953, George and his friend went to a ballroom dance in Brierley Town Hall, where destiny would have it that he met the love of his life, Lillian. As they danced into the night, she trembled. When he asked her why she was shaking, she answered, saying, "I've never danced with a man like this before." Then he turned to her and said, "No, you're shaking with passion." They went on to date for a couple of years, and as their love for each other blossomed, they would go on to be married on May 14th, 1955, at Wolverhampton Register Office, and remain so for over 66 years. Within their union came 5 children, 18 grandchildren, and 19 great-grandchildren whom he loved dearly. He would often give them names after they were born, like the Wrestler, the Conqueror, the Doctor, the Deacon, the Bishop and the Preacher, to name a few. Anytime he traveled abroad and came back home, he would always have a gift. Whether in the week or on a weekend, he'd always come home into the house and say, "Sorry, hey lover, I brought you some flowers." He'd always refer to mom as his girlfriend and she her boyfriend. They were inseparable and often spoke in unison. They were soulmates. There's nothing that he wouldn't do for his family. And every opportunity he had, he would always install values and sound advice, reminding us that prayer was the ultimate key and to invest in God. In June 1959, his life would take a meaningful turn after going to bed one night and having a dream that he saw a grave without God in it. This would be the beginning of his conviction in the faith. Later that same year, he was baptized in Jesus' name at the Baptist Tabernacle on Staveley Road, Wolverhampton. He went on to become a Sunday school teacher at Mount Shiloh Apostolic Church on Old Hall Street, Wolverhampton, under the leadership of Bishop H.D. Brown, and started work in the field for souls. By 1962, he was ordained a minister by Bishop Brown, where Dudley Church was birthed out of his ministry. He would then go on to leave his job at Garrington's and pursue full-time ministry, where more churches were birthed: Smethwick, West Bromwich, Redditch, Worcester, Whiteheath, and Harrow in London, all as fruits of his ministry. Throughout George's ministry, he was an earnest servant who had a passion for Christ, a man of distinction, a spiritual father, mentor, and friend to all who came to know him. For those that knew him, George was a man of wisdom and dignity and possessed a great sense of humor as he loved to laugh. He lived a prayerful life. He lived a prayerful life, spending countless hours on his knees, morning, noon, and night. Prayer was ultimately the most essential and highly prioritized part of his ministry. As Psalms 91, verse 1 goes on to say, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty," and that is exactly the kind of life that George lived. On the 20th of October, 2020, George slept peacefully away to be with the Lord. As 2 Timothy 4, verses 7 through 8 go on to say, "I have fought a good fight, I have finished my course, I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness." He was survived by his wife, Lillian, of 66 years, children Leroy, Carl, Kim, Peter, Tanya and Timothy, including that of grandsons, Jonathan and Christian Peter Kim, who he raised as his sons. Siblings, Leela, Ben, Keith, Howard, Aldith, Lola, Merlene, and sister-in-law, Mary. 18 grandchildren, 19 great-grandchildren, and a host of nieces and nephews. He will forever be in our hearts, gone but never forgotten.
Thank God for bringing us this far, and we appreciate the tributes and the love that has been shown here today. Minister Campbell is here from the Dudley Church, Mother Ferron, and all of the saints of God, the many lives that Elder Peter King has touched, certainly on behalf of all of the pastors and our national leadership team of Bethel. Elder Peter King served for so many years, the saints, all of the officers. We certainly want to register our honor for the life and legacy of Elder George Peter King. We're living this life, and we do everything that we do in ministry to hear two words: well done. And sometimes you're not going to hear that while you're doing the work here on earth. There will be many that do not remember. There will be many that don't even think to say it. But we are confident of this one thing, that after a life of service, after a life of faith, Elder Peter King will hear those words, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. Come now, I will make you ruler over many." It's time for the word of the Lord, and we're blessed today to have Overseer Lance Dinnell, a spiritual son of Elder Peter King. Overseer Dinnell serves as the pastor of the Bethel Church in Cardiff, South Wales, and our colleague on the National Ecclesiastical Council, Overseer of the Southwest District. We're blessed, and I'm sure that our hearts are going to be blessed today with the word of God that comes. Before the overseer comes, we're blessed to have one of the great gifts that the Lord has blessed our church with. Elder David Copeland will come, amen, and minister in song. And then the next voice you will hear will be that of the preacher for this time, Overseer. Dad's sister is here from New York. And his niece. Aunt Merlene. And Lillian. Leah. God bless you. Just wave your hand, Auntie. God bless you from New York. Thank God for you. Thank God for you coming all of this way. We appreciate you in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Let us praise the name of the Lord. Let us give God praise. First of all, I greet the family. Massive condolences. My love goes out to you, and I just thank God for this great man of God. He touched me, and he wasn't my dad. He was your father, but we have all felt the effects of Elder George Peter King in our lives, and he will never be forgotten. I just want to pay my respects to the rostrum and all the great men on the rostrum. God bless you all. Amen. It was sometime in the very early 80s, somebody put on a concert at West Bromwich Town Hall, and our choir was invited to sing. So we had a van full of people with some equipment and everything, and we were rushing to the concert, and just like before, the van decides he doesn't want to go to the concert. So we were stuck. So we decided what we would do. We would get the folks, get the choir to the venue, and then we'll see what happens from there. So I went with them. When we got there, I saw Elder Peter King. Young David says, "What are you doing?" So I says, "With the choir. The choir will be singing today, but the van's broken down, so we don't know what we can do." He says, "Well, you sing then." And I was never a soloist or anything. Everything I've done with the choir. And I'm like, okay. And I found a song. And ever since I sang that song, Elder P, everywhere he saw me, "You're going to sing this song, Dave?" And I wore the song out, but it was with joy. And I'm going to sing it now. And may the Lord continue to live in the memory of our Elder Peter King, in Jesus' name. Whenever I find myself in time of need, when I really, really need a friend, you're always there to hear my prayer. You bring the sun out to light my days up. You make my love grow.
every day. You bring the stars out to light my night, sir. You make the darkness roll away. Whenever I'm alone, I'm really not alone. Your loving presence, by faith I see. You comfort me, and you never let me down. You bring the sun out to light my days up. And you make love grow every day. You bring the stars out to light my nights up. You make the darkness roll away. I reach for you, and you reach for me. No matter where I go, you'll be there. Never too far, far from my heart. Said I'll always have you here, and I'll always have you near, to bring the sun out, to light my days up. You make my love grow, my love grow every day. You bring the stars out, whoa, to light my nights up. You make the darkness roll away. You bring the stars out to light my nights up. You make the darkness roll away.
God, today we thank God in this atmosphere for his presence, and we're grateful to the Lord for, amen, his goodness and his mercy towards us. God is good, God is great, and greatly to be praised. Surely today my heart is full of memories and affection for our dear Elder Peterkin. I want to thank God for his input in my life. I remember many years ago, I don't know why, but he really took an interest in me.
Right.
And perhaps he saw things in me I didn't even see in myself, but he loved me like a father. There are many people in my life who have inputted in my life, who have contributed to making me into who I am today. And without a shadow of a doubt, Elder George Peterkin is one of those men. And I give God praise for him, his life, and for his legacy. And on behalf of my wife, and I'm a family, you know, we just want to extend our condolences and our love to the family. It's palpable in here. You can feel the emotion, you can feel the pain. But in the midst of all of this, there is joy. God is reassuring us in the midst of all of this that he is with us and he's with you. Mother Peterkin, entire family, extended family, our prayers are with you, and we love you with the love of the Lord. God bless you. I remember in the early days, I used to, in my holidays, First time I ever went to Digbeth Station in Birmingham, he would pick me up from the station, take me around, take me to prayer meetings and do all of those things. And, you know, those are precious, precious memories to me. Precious memories to me. And to God be the glory and to God be the praise for a great man of God. Amen. And then I know protocol has been established. I want to thank God for my bishop, Bishop Dexter Edmund, and all the bishops and clergy on the platform, to our singers and praise group, to the songsters and musicians, to everybody. Greetings once again in the mighty name of Jesus. Let me briefly just share, as was said, Elder Peter Kim was a soul winner. Yes, he had that anointing on his life, and God blessed him and rewarded him bountifully. So I would like to just share with you a word of comfort from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Praise the Lord. Thank God for the host pastor as well, Pastor Brown, and God is good. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 13. I'll just read down to the end. But I would not have you be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this I say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent or precede them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. And for the family, for everybody, wherefore comfort one another with these words. I would just like to share a thought, praise God, around the theme, if you like, but connecting it to this particular passage of scripture, the believer's guarantee, the believer's guarantee. Now, Jesus made it clear that anybody who believes in him has a guarantee. The guarantee of eternal life. He said to Martha at the grave of Lazarus, where there was weeping, where there was mourning, that your brother will rise again. And Martha, being Martha, outspoken, always ready to give her view, wore her passion on her sleeves, she said, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. Hallelujah. Jesus said to her, your brother's going to rise again. Hallelujah. Praise the name of God. She said, well, I know he's going to rise again in the last day. Jesus retorted, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, praise God, amen, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. And that is the believer's guarantee. There are many things, beloved, that in our world that we are given guarantee and promises of. But those guarantees can fail. You buy a product, you buy goods, you buy services in our world, and it comes with a guarantee, but sometimes when you call on the guarantee, it fails. But I want you to know that if Jesus is your guarantee, if you believe in Jesus, his guarantee will never fail you. Hallelujah. Jesus, notice, he says, I am the resurrection and the life. Meaning he has the monopoly over the living and the dead. Nobody comes into our world unless Jesus says so. And nobody leaves the world unless the Lord allows it. So he is in control of the living and the dead. So when we talk about the believer's guarantee today, we're talking about belief in Jesus Christ. Jesus said, if you believe in me, hallelujah, praise God, even though you were dead, yet shall you live. Praise God. And Jesus is talking about first resurrection here, resurrection from the dead. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. Notice, he raises the dead, the resurrector. But not only that, but he has the power to give the risen dead life. Praise the name of God. So Jesus, beloved, is the one to believe in. The Christian religion is the only religion in the world that believes in a God that became man, went to the cross for our sins, went into the grave and come back from the dead. I think I'll buy that. I'll think I'll invest in that. When you invest your faith in Jesus, you will never lose. Many people have put their trust in the wrong things, in the wrong person. But guess what? If you put your trust in Jesus, he will never let you down. Oh, can we bless the name of the Lord? Can we praise the name of the Lord? The believer's guarantee must be believed. Because if we don't believe it, we can't get the guarantee. And Jesus is our guarantor. So in order to get the benefit of what he's offering, I have to go to the guarantor. A lot of people want life, but they're missing out the one who gives life. And Jesus is the life giver. He's the one who woke us up this morning. He's the one who set us on our way. So Jesus now, beloved, is the author and finisher of life. To him be praise, and to him be glory, and to him be honor. If you're sitting in here today and you don't have this guarantee, I appeal to you to make Jesus your choice. I appeal to you to believe in the Lord with all your heart. God will not let you down. People will let you down. Friends will let you down. But Jesus will never let you down. Can we bless his name today? Can we bless his name? Can we bless his name? You see, beloved, the believer's guarantee is a real hope. Amen. Not a figment of our imagination, but that's what our elder George Peterkin had. He had the believer's guarantee. A belief in Jesus that was so firm, hallelujah, and so steadfast that when he left here, he knew where he was going. Oh, praise the name of God. You see, when a man comes into this world, praise God, he doesn't know too much about it. But when we leave this world, I believe we know where we're going. Hallelujah. And if you know where you're going, if you have the guarantee, can somebody say hallelujah? Hallelujah. Can somebody say hallelujah? Hallelujah? And so now, beloved, what we need to see in the text, and I'm going to be brief, is that Martha was losing hope. Martha thought it was all over. Martha thought death in this life, sleep in this life, meant the end of the journey, the end of the process. But Jesus stepped in and turned the situation around and transformed a funeral into a party. Amen. Hallelujah. He dried up their tears when he said, Lazarus, come forth. And he woke Lazarus out of his slumber, out of his sleep, out of death, and brought him back for the family. Yes, I'm saying to you today, beloved, comfort yourself with these words. It has been said that the average human being throughout their life sleeps one third of their life. One third of your life is taken up in sleeping. Praise the name of God. What that teaches me, beloved, is that sleep, praise God, is something that was a result of sin. We weren't meant to sleep. We were meant to live eternally. But what we do when we sleep, every time we sleep and we get up, what we show, praise God, is our fragility. Right. Praise God, because yes, we become weary, we become tired, and then we sleep. And then we get up, and some of us still feel tired. Anybody been in that road? Yeah, you get up, and you still feel tired. 8 hours sleep, still feel tired. But in that great getting up morning, in the day, praise God, when God will call his church home, when we get up, there will be no lethargy. When we get up, there'll be no tiredness. You know why? Because we will have the believer's guarantee. We read Paul's words in Thessalonians when he said, those that sleep in Christ shall not prevent those, praise God, amen, who are alive. Praise God. So those who are alive will not prevent those that sleep. So what he's saying here, beloved, is that sleep in Scripture is another way of describing death, is another way of talking about physical death. So the believers, if you want to use it as a euphemism, amen, a softer way of saying it, the believers sleep in Jesus. If we believe that Jesus, amen, that those who sleep in Jesus shall be with Jesus, then we believe we have the guarantee. I'm so glad for this guarantee, beloved, because guess what? Sometimes when the alarm is going off, you can't wake some people up. Praise God. You ever had that experience trying to get people up? The alarm is going off. Amen. You're shouting to get them up. You can't get them. But when Jesus calls us back from our sleep, the sleep of death, hallelujah, nothing will be able to hold us down. You may be 6 foot under, but guess what? God is going to provide a new body. God is going to provide a celestial body. So this, praise God, mortal body, this terrestrial body from the terrain, hallelujah, must give way to the heavenly body, the celestial. Paul said to the church at Corinth, amen, this mortal must give way, amen, to immortality. And this corruptible must give way, praise God, to incorruption. So when, praise God, amen, corruption, amen, is superseded by incorruption, and when mortality, amen, is taken over by immortality, then shall be brought to pass a saying that death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, he said, where is your sting? Oh, grave, where is your victory? Because when you have the believer's guarantee, you can speak like that. When you have the Jesus guarantee, amen, the guarantee of life and life eternal, you can talk like that. When you know where you're going, hallelujah, you can praise the name of the Lord Jesus with that assurance that you have that guarantee. Can somebody praise the Lord? So, beloved, what I'm saying today is we sleep. Amen. Praise God. And we get up. We sleep and we get up. We sleep, we get up, we sleep. One third of our life. But the time will come, beloved, when we'll sleep on earth for the last time. Unless Jesus comes when we're alive and remain. But guess what? Jesus has already made provision. I'm so glad I serve a God that makes provision. He made provision on Calvary when he died. Because when Jesus died, he dealt with the root cause of death. And sin was the root cause of death. So when Jesus died on the cross, sin and death, amen, sin and death was subdued. Why? Because the power of sin and penalty of sin was conquered on Calvary. So now Jesus could go into the grave and come out of the grave, and rigor mortis couldn't hold him down. Come on, corruption couldn't hold him down, because he had power over sin. And Paul said, where there is no sin, death will not have its sting. So death couldn't hold him down. We sing the song, no grave shall hold my body down. For the trump of God shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise. And since we have this hope, we ought to rejoice today. I believe, amen, praise God, our Elder Peterkin has this hope. He has this guarantee. Praise God, praise God. He didn't die without a hope. He died with his hope. I believe where he is, beloved, is better than where we are. Yes. Come on. Because when the saints of God go up to glory, they go to a place, a special department. The Bible called it the spirit, where the place where the spirits of just men are made perfect. Oh, praise the name of God. When you get to that realm, when you get to that area, praise the name of God. Hallelujah. You know, hallelujah, that you've made it. I want you to know today, beloved, that he had the guarantee. Comfort yourself with these words. He's not, praise God, he's not dead, he's just sleeping. Amen. He's just taken off, praise God, his earthly clothes. And God has fixed up a brand new suit. Amen. For he has transformed the vile body, this flesh that goes back to the earth, and clothed us with a new body. How do we know that? We know that, and I'm closing, because, praise God, even in Scripture we read that when Moses died in Mount Nebo, he died in Mount Pisgah. And we read about that in the last chapter of the book of Deuteronomy. Elijah, praise God, was carried up into heaven with a whirlwind into glory. Hallelujah, in the Old Testament. But when we read the New Testament, Jesus went to the Mount of Transfiguration with Peter, James, and John. And the Bible said his face shone like the sun. Praise God. His clothes changed. Praise God. And Moses appeared. And Elijah appeared. The same Moses, amen, that died at Nebo. The same Elijah that was swept up at Jordan. They appeared to Jesus in the New Testament. And we read that they talked with Jesus. Talking with Jesus, Moses and Elijah talking with Jesus, and they were having a time. And when Peter saw this, he said, it's good for us to be here. He said, let's build three tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, hallelujah, and one for Elijah, praise God. And when they vanished, amen, they only saw Jesus only. Let me conclude by saying, beloved, Jesus Christ, amen, has the power over sin and death, and no grave shall hold our bodies down. Amen. Praise God, because we sleep in Jesus. You see, you have to believe in Jesus to sleep in Jesus. If you don't believe in Jesus, you sleep outside of Jesus. Come on, praise the name of God. And that's the reason why, beloved, it's very important to believe Jesus now. He's not asking for our money. He's not asking for our intelligence. He's just asking for our belief. Whatever you believe in, beloved, that will determine where you go. And will you hear the word of the Lord today and make Jesus your choice? If you're in this house and you don't know God, if you hear the word of the Lord, will you make Jesus your choice today? For Jesus said, I am the resurrection. Nobody's coming back from the dead unless he says so. Praise God. Nobody's going to rise unless he calls their name. And I want to make sure that I'm ready for the first resurrection. Hallelujah. Praise God. Because everybody's coming back from the dead. Daniel said, many that sleep in the dust shall come back from the dead. Some to everlasting, amen, life, and some to shame and contempt. But we're all coming back, beloved. But I want to make sure I'm back in the first resurrection. And so we read in the Bible, blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection. On such second death hath no power. Second death is for those who don't have the guarantee. First resurrection are for those who have guarantee in Jesus. When all has been said and done, I want you to know the time will come when preaching will finish. Amen. The time will come when singing down here will finish. Amen. The time will come, beloved, when the opportunity to know God will go. But now is the acceptable time. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart. God is calling somebody and letting you know that you can take out your guarantee with him today. If you believe in Jesus, as the scripture has said, then something wonderful will happen in your soul. The Holy Ghost can meet you. The Holy Ghost can fill you. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusteth in him. I found out that by making Jesus my choice, he turns my mourning into dancing. He turns my sorrow into joy. I found out that what the Bible said is true. It is a reality in my life, praise God, that those who believe in Jesus will remain with Jesus. Those who stay with Jesus, Jesus will stay with them. Notice he said, I'm closing, I'm winding down now. Notice he said, if you believe in me, he that believeth in me, he that continues to believe in me shall never die. That teaches me the believer never dies. We just go through the channel, praise God, from this life through a channel called death, called sleep, praise God, and we go on to the other side into everlasting life, praise God. That's why David said, yea, though I walk through the channel, I'm walking through the valley of the shadow of death, but I've got my guarantee. He said, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Hallelujah. You prepare before me a table in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. And then he said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. I'm so glad for the guarantee. If somebody knows about the guarantee, will you bless the name of the Lord with me? Will you bless the name of the Lord with me? So the Apostle Paul said, I know you helped me. I know you held mankind under a grip. But he said, oh, death, where is your sting? Hallelujah. Jesus removed the sting of death. He said, oh, grave, where is your victory? So in Jesus, beloved, we have the victory. I want you to know, beloved, that we have the victory in Jesus because we have his guarantee. Praise the name of God. Praise the name. It's not in Valhalla. Come on. It's not in Valhalla. It's not in reincarnation. It's in resurrection in Jesus' name. Come on. You can try cryonics, but cryonics will leave you in tears. It's in Jesus' name. You have to understand it's in Jesus. And when you buy it, praise God, when you grasp it, when you believe it, when you trust his word, he will never let you down. I want to bless the name of the Lord. I want to praise the name of the Lord. Sleep in Jesus, elder. Hallelujah. I know he's sleeping in Jesus. And when Jesus, some sweet day, some wonderful day, when Jesus, praise God, says, wake up, elder, he's going to say, wake up to all of us who have that guarantee. And there's going to be a shift in the heavenlies and a move on earth, and there's going to be a catching up together some sweet day. I'm going away. Hallelujah. We're going to leave this world no more to roam some sweet day. Hallelujah. God is going to come back for his church. I don't know the hour and I don't know the time, but he went away not to stay, and he's coming back again. If you want the guarantee, you can come to Jesus now. You don't have to go back out of here the way you came. The elder Peter Kin, I know, always wanted the sermon to be preached at a funeral. He always wanted that. Praise the name of God. And I get the feeling he's saying, preach. Come on, preacher. Hallelujah. He's saying, preach, because there's still souls to save. Hallelujah. In this pandemic, if you don't get it, God is speaking to you in the pandemic and saying, give your heart to me. Give your heart to Jesus. And when you do that, he will work miracles in your life. What an awesome God. What a wonderful God. What a great God. You don't have to be afraid anymore. I said, you don't have to be afraid anymore, because death hath no terror. Amen. For the what? For the blood-washed ones. Oh, glory. Hallelujah to the Lamb. You see, death tried to back up Jesus, you see, but it couldn't hold him. Amen. David said it was not possible to hold him. Praise God. Corruption tried but couldn't hold him. Praise the name. Rigor mortis tried to kick in, but it couldn't hold him. He emerged triumphant. He emerged victorious out of death and said, if you follow me, you're coming up like I did, out of the grave. Oh, bless the name of God. Death tried, but death couldn't succeed. The Bible said he has abolished death and brought life and immortality
authority to light through the gospel. He has abolished death. Hallelujah. And for those who have the guarantee, oh, praise the name of God, we can rejoice. Come on. That's why, beloved, we, the believers, don't have, this is not a mourning. This is a celebration of life. Come on. If you know where you're going, man, you rejoice with Elder and know that one of these days, if we have the guarantee, we'll be with him too. But you have to take out your guarantee with the guarantor, and Jesus is the guarantor. You have to go to him. You can't circumvent him. You can't go around him. You have to come to Jesus to get resurrection power. And I feel him in my hands. I feel him in my soul. I can feel him all over. God's all over me. Can I bless him? Will you bless the Lord with me? If you can stand, will you stand on your feet and bless the name of Jesus? Just bless him. Just bless him. Just give him praise. Just give him a praise. Just give him a praise. Just give him a praise. God bless you. God bless you.
The believer's guarantee. We thank God for his word today, reminding us of the hope of everlasting life. This is what Elder Peter King lived for. And this is what, in dying, Elder Peter King died, but he is not dead. He is with the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And so today, Bishop Shirley is coming to pray the closing prayer. But if there's someone here today that desires to make Jesus your choice, this is the moment. This is the time for God to enter our hearts. Bishop Shirley.
Praise the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Just before I pray, I must give my condolences to Mother Peter King, the entire Peter King family, to Bishop Bester and all of the rest of bishops. And I'm going to make it very short. When Elder Peter King, I remember we were at his bedside in the hospital. Brother Timothy, Peter, was a young man there, and he held a young man and he said, "Son, invest in him up there." At that time, I did not believe he would have lived out a week. And the Lord has taken him through months after that. And he always says to me, before you preach, you should sing. I can't sing because we haven't got much time. But just very short before I pray. Teardrops will never stain the street of the city. No reed, nor death on my mansion door. Teardrops aren't welcome beyond the gates of glory, because the heart will never break any more. I've never met one man without sorrow. I've never looked into eyes with no pain. But there's a land where death is a stranger. It's that land where we never shall grow whole. Tears will never stain the street of the city. No reed, nor death on my mansion door. Teardrops aren't welcome beyond the gates of glory, 'cause the heart will never break anymore. I noticed that as the loved ones came in and they could not stop crying, but just after they started, the church started to praise God, Mother King stopped crying and praising God. Tears will never stain the street of the city. No more wreath, no more death on my mansion door. Teardrops aren't welcome beyond the gates of glory, because the heart will never break anymore. Let us pray. God of Abraham, the only God that there is, we worship and adore you. We thank you for the life of your servant. He has touched many of us' life. There are many things that we will remember him always. God, we've got him on CD when he visits our assembly. And there are memories that we will never forget. We pray today as we are about to go and lay his remainder to the ground to rest. We know that you gave life and you take it away. And because of that, we commit your servant into your hand. Bless the family. Bless this assembly. And many others that would love to be here today, we pray, God, that your blessing will touch their lives. We thank you for your manservant. We thank you for him, God. We honor you for him. He has touched our lives today. And because of that, we are here and we are rejoicing. Although we are sad, but we are rejoicing. Father, receive your servant into your care as we give you thanks and praise as we go from here. Lord, go with us to the remainder of the service. Have your own way now, we pray. We ask it all in Jesus' name.
Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus is the best thing I've ever, ever done. Falling in love with Jesus. Oh!
And the light, saith the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, and not another. For we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain that we cannot carry anything out. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. For we know that if this earthly house of this tabernacle be dissolved. We have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Let us all pray. Father, we come before thy presence one more time. We hallow thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you, God, for you do not make mistakes, but you are sovereign. You are our great eternal wonder, holy counselor, Zion's righteous governor, the great I am. And in all things, Father, we give you thanks. Thank you for our dear elder and husband and father, that he is somewhere around the throne of God. Lord, you taught us through your word that there remaineth a rest for the people of God. We thank you, God, for making that provision for us this day. Bless us and keep us in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord make me to know my end and the measure of my days. What is that I may know how frail I am? Behold, thou hast made my days as a handbreadth, and my age is as nothing before thee. Verily, every man at his best state is altogether vanity. Surely, every man walketh in vain shore. Surely they are disquieted in vain. He heapeth up riches and knoweth not whom shall gather them. And now, Lord, what way I for? My hope is in thee. Deliver me from all my transgressions. Make me not the reproach of the foolish. I was dumb and opened not my mouth, because thou didst it. Remove thy stroke away from me, for I am consumed by the blow of thine hand. When thou will rebuke, dost correct man from his iniquity. Thou makest his beauty to consume away like a moth. Surely every man is vanity. Yes. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and give ear unto my cry. Hold not thy peace at my tears, yes, for I am a stranger, yes, with thee, and a sojourner, as all my fathers were. Oh, spare me, that I may recover strength before I go hence and be no more. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations, before the mountains were brought forth, or even thou hast formed the earth and the world therein, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. For as much as the spirit of the departed has returned to God, who gave it, we therefore commit his body to the ground. Glory to God. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the great and general resurrection in the last days, and the life of the world to come through our Lord Savior Jesus Christ, at whom second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world and the earth, and the corruptible body of those who slept in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor, and their works do follow them. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Let us say the prayer that the Lord taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Let all God's people say amen.
Amen.
One more time, amen.
Amen.
Praise God. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Glory to God. If anyone has any flowers.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saints have gathered over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, on that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share. Oh, when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Everybody, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all our life is over and our works on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Yes, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Oh, goodbye world, I stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin,
I stay no longer with you. I've made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I've made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Goodbye, world. Goodbye, world. Oh, I stay no longer with you.
Goodbye, dangers of sin.
I stay no longer with you. I made up my mind to go God's way
the rest of my life.
Everybody, I made up my mind to go God's way
the rest of my life.
Oh, goodbye, world. Goodbye, world. Goodbye, world. Oh, I stay no longer with you. Goodbye, pleasures
of sin. I stay no longer with you.
Oh, I made up my mind. The rest of my life, I made up my mind to go God's way. Praise God when we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
Praise God.
Yeah. You remember, I went to see Elder Peter King in hospital. And he said to me that he hadn't burped for about 4 days, and he wanted to burp. And I says, oh, well, we've just come to see you. He says, lay your hand on me. And as I laid my hands on him, he started to burp, burp. Let us all bow our heads in prayer. Let's all bow our heads in prayer.
Yeah. Heavenly Father, this evening, Lord, we thank you for today. Mighty God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord Jesus. On this occasion, Lord, we lay your servant to rest, Lord God. We pray for the family this evening, Lord. You cover them under your blood. Wrap your arms around them, Lord. Speak comfortable word into their spirit, I pray. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, great God, we pray that even one soul can be birthed out of this day. Bless us now, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. As we see one for another, go with us today and keep us, Lord, out of accident from danger. In Jesus' name, amen.
Sleep on, beloved. Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon the Savior's breast. We love you well. But Jesus loves you best. Good night, good night, good night. We love you, good night, good night, good night. Praise God, we love you, good night, good night, good night. One more time, we love you, good night, good night, good night. Praise God, we love you, good night. Good night, good night. Just one more time, we love you, good night. Good night, good night. A Pentecostal one. We love you, good night. We love you, good night. We love you, good night. Praise God, we love you, good night. Good night, good night. Praise God, we love you, good night. Good night, good night. One more time, we love you, good night. Good night, good night. One more time for the sixth time, we love you, good night. Good night, good night. God bless you. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, let it be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. God bless you.
This is revival with a capital R. Revival. I am only sorry tonight that Mother Peter King couldn't make it. We've been married 60 years this month. Years and still courting. Praise God. Praise God. I said the other day, we are a product of our environment. We had a van load of brethren came from Dudley, and I am sorry that the whole church wasn't here so that they could have a bit of experience of what I talk about in the 60s. Praise God. Because, you see, with this meeting tonight now, we just feel like we could stay here all night. Don't it's true? Praise God.
In this moment today, my name is Shane. My beautiful wife, Tatiana, is with you in the physical, and I'm here in the virtual as we remember the incredible man of God that Granddad was. And I know that Granddad actually wouldn't even want me to talk about him right now, but he would actually want me to take this moment to talk about him. Granddad would actually want me to take this moment to tell you to invest in God. To invest in God. I know it seems hard right now, but invest in God. And I know you got some loss right now, but invest in God, because to live is Christ and to die is gain. And so invest in God. And I know that the sorrow is mounting up right now, but invest in God. And I know the valley seems really, really low right now, but to invest in God. And I know you feel like you're in the fire and you're in the storm, but invest in God. I know that Granddad would actually want me to tell you that Mark 8 verse 36 says that what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world yet lose his own soul? That as we talk about profits and gains and losses, we're talking about an investment. Invest in God. Because when you invest in God, Jesus Christ deposits the Holy Spirit to live inside of you, to lead you, to guide you, and direct you, to be a light unto your feet and a lamp unto your path, to convict you, to challenge you, and to comfort you in moments such as this, in moments to give you peace that transcends all understanding. Invest in God. It's your choice today. You get to determine the kind of legacy that you will leave behind. Will it be a Psalms 91 type legacy like Granddad? Or will it be a legacy where it was all about you? You decide. Will you invest in God? The choice is yours. In Jesus' precious name, amen.
My sincere condolences to Mother Peterkin and family, as well as the Dudley Assembly. We accept that Pastor Peterkin has now finally arrived with the Lord for everlasting life. He was well honoured and respected as a good man of God, and therefore we know he has left a good spiritual legacy. So on behalf of my family, we'll continue to cover you all in our prayers in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Condolence to Mother Peterkin and her family, and also the church family. Elder Peterkin was truly a great man of God, a great prayer warrior and a preacher. We will remember him for many things, but one thing we will remember him for, and I quote,
speak up to be heard, stand up to be seen, shut up to be appreciated. Rest in peace, my brother.
George is truly a prayer warrior and a great man of God. Today, I know his soul is resting in the arms of Jesus. Big brother, we love you dearly, but Jesus loves you best. And to Miss Lil and the rest of the family, be strong, we love you, and we are praying for you.
Hello, this is Paula, the daughter of Lola Peterkin. I'm representing my siblings here today, and we just wanted to give our love and tell you how sorry we are for your loss, and we are praying for you. We love you all. God bless you and keep you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. God's perpetual peace be upon Elder Peter King until the trumpet sound for that great convocation in the year when we shall meet together at the great marriage supper of the Lamb. Until then, we continue as best as we can. We send our love to each and every one as we all mourn together. We know that Mother Peterkin has lost her boyfriend. We know that Elder Peterkin was her best friend and companion. The church in Dudley has lost a great warrior, but God knows all things best. The Apostle John said, I heard a voice from heaven saying, write unto me, blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. From henceforth, ye the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them. So today we celebrate his life, but we recognize that he's now resting from his labor, but his legacy live on.
To Mother Peterkin and family, on behalf of the Bethel Central Region of Churches, Evangelist Coronet and myself, please accept our condolences on the passing of Elder George Peterkin. A renowned prayer warrior, his ceaseless labor has turned into reward, and his life and legacy will always remain in the apostolic body of Christ. Our prayers are with you all. God bless you in Jesus' name.
This is Bishop Simpson, giving my condolences on the death of Elder Peterkin. May the Lord bless his soul.
Lord, I'm running.
Lord, I'm running.
Trying to make a hundred.
Trying to make a hundred.
99
and a half.
It won't do.
Won't do.
Lord, I'm running.
Lord, I'm running.
Trying to make a hundred.
Trying to make a hundred.
99
and a half.
Won't do.
Won't do.
Lord, I'm running.
Lord, I'm running.
Trying to make a hundred.
Every day.
You got to live a little bit better.